Independence history, and I believed that, you know, there was nothing incongruous about being a peacenik with an arsenal in its house. Now, but things change and evolve, hopefully. And what happened with me is when I just got clean, just gotten out of jail, started my life all over again, my ex-wife handed me an out-of-control teenage boy. I said, here, you might have met him. The first thing that Justin did when he got back in the room, the first thing he did was he went in my bedroom when I wasn't looking and he found the 9mm pistol that I kept loaded under the mattress. And he hid it, and he wouldn't admit to me that he had it. And I knew he was lying. I still know when he's lying. And I just didn't know what to do. I was terrified. You're not doing your best parenting in 4.5, 5 months clean. And I was having enough trouble taking care of myself. And so I couldn't figure out what else to do, so I called my brother, and he came over, and we strip searched Justin and made sure he did not have the gun, because all I could come up with was some sort of scheme to make sure Justin was where the gun wasn't. So I could sleep that night anyway. And so we made sure he didn't have the gun, we loaded him in the truck. It was sort of like trying to wrestle a live deer into your vehicle. And then we took him to a wilderness camp, they call it, in Hickman County, and you know, a place where people send their kids when they can't control them. And I'm not proud of that. I'm pretty sure they were hiring him out for slave labor to the state. But I didn't know what else to do, so I just dropped him off and wrote him a check. Now, it was January, and they were sleeping in tents. So about 4:30 the next morning, he called me and told me where the fucking gun was. Whether Justin learned anything or not, you'll have to ask him from that experience. But what I learned is I haven't had a gun in my house since, and nor will I ever again. And some people would call that, in this society, they call that flip-flopping or something. And I call it having a profound experience that affects your life personally and deeply and changing the way that you live. And if I hadn't learned to do that at some point, I wouldn't be standing here tonight. So now when I sing this song, at the time of death, I'll fight a bit of war. Saw my first pistol in a general store, in a general store. I was 13, thought it was the finest thing I ever had seen. I said, I got yells in the window to the hood. I'ma drop a gun and it's gonna blow up, gonna blow up. Getting on a stand, I'ma see the pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, devil's right hand. I'ma see the pistol is a devil's right hand. Got them all cold. Shoot as fast as mine, I'm gonna shoot over my soul. Over my soul. So my fam ass, you can get you into trouble, but you can't get you out. And I went and got myself a cool 45. Got a piecemeal that I never knew why. Never knew why. Didn't understand. I'ma say the pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. I'ma say the pistol is a devil's right hand. I'ma say the pistol is a devil's right hand. I've gone to the car in a cup and a tan. All of my cheating and I shut the door down. Shut the door down. Never told us hoes and never had a chance to drop. Traveling in the morning and a dreaming out bed. That's when I'm feeling like it does. Sitting like it does. Got your own man. Nothing but your trigger but the devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. Mama sees a pistol is the devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Nothing but your trigger but the devil's right hand. Marxism, Tissel is a devil's drive to hang you.